So here we go then. The puck is down on this one. Dundee Stars against the Belfast Giants on Dundee Stars Live. Thank you very much indeed for your company. Hope you enjoy the game this evening. See the Giants win the draw and lock us into the zone in down the right-hand side. Work this one back out to the line. Shot comes in there. A lot of traffic in front. The puck is collected in front here by Valentini. Sends it across the neutral zone. And Nass will push us in down the left-hand side for the Stars. Brian Dell will give chase on this one. Stars pop this out. In front. A chance on the backhand and it's across the line. A goal for the Stars in 30 seconds in this game. And what a start to this for the home team. 30 seconds gone. Dundee 1, Belfast 0.
Yeah, what a start indeed. It looks like it's a goal from, if I'm right thinking, Brendan Harms.
Yep.
And yeah, a huge one for him. This place erupted very early, 30 seconds on the clock, as you say, Dave. And he's scored his second goal of the season. And wow, that was a fast and furious start from the Stars. This place has certainly got alive now. Been missing this season, it's noisy.
Yep. And McKay gets a stick on this one. Finds Walker. Whoa, Walker checked into the boards. And Curran picks up the loose one. Giants again move in. Here is Prince. Drops it back for Friend. Tipping close. And it's gone in. Top corner. Good movement in from the point there. And the tip in front gave Kevin Carr zero chance on that one. And a very quick equaliser for the Belfast Giants. Dundee 1, Belfast 1, 17-39 in the first period remain.
Yeah, what a huge comeback here. Very timorous as well. And none other than Johnny Curran scoring that one. His third goal of the season. Well, he likes to annoy us in here, doesn't he, Dave? Johnny Curran. Regardless of who he's playing for.
Yeah.
But yeah, anyway, a big one. 1-1 with 17:39 left in the first.
Stars will exit the zone. Valentini dumps it in. Kevin chases doubt. Oh, leaves this one for Valentini. Valentini in close again. Chance on the doorstep. Oh, and just past the target there. It's a very similar move to the one that got the Stars a goal. Harms sent them pass, goes behind Valentini. Here is Valentini again. Twisting and turning on that left-hand side, sends it in, and a chance on the rebound. Bescolani is sprawled on the ice there, and the Stars have got a good bit of pressure here. Fire this one out. Chance comes in again, and it's blocked and knocked to the corner. Craig Moore sends it round. Harms again will send this one round the corner, but it's gone all the way back into the neutral zone. Oh, nice pass out the zone, and through goes Cooper in down the left-hand side. Still going, Cooper takes it in close. Flicks it out here, chance for Norris, taken away from him, just in the nick of time, and the charge, oh, nice pass through, chance for Rinaldi, Rinaldi shoots, and what a save that is from Bescolani. Well, I tell you, that's a tremendous pass, I think that's from Elmer. Caught in possession down there, Sean Allen. Britton will pick this up though. Oh, pass out the zone, it's cut out, oh, hand in the air, and McKay's going to go to the box. Bescolani on his way. And he makes it as well. Extra skater is on. The Giants have got six on then. Keep this inside the zone. Friend plays this one back. He'll take it back to give and go. Out to the line. Curte sends it across to the right. The Giants can take their time here. Build something. Curte to the top of the circle. Oh, shoots and it's gone in. Friend will fire that one. There's a couple of blokes in front of Carr. Blocking his sight on that one. And the Giants have gone from a goal down to a goal in front with 10:54 left in the first.
Let's watch his back from Jacob Friend. It's his second goal of the season. And as you say, Carr was just, he couldn't really get much of an eye on that, to be fair. A very, very good finish all the same from Jacob Friend. And he gives the Giants a 2-1 lead here on the road in the Dundee Ice Arena.
Long range pass, looking at, whoops, a wee collision there. I think Elmer is okay, but gingerly getting back to the skates. No,
no,
no, it's not okay.
Not looking good at all.
No. Feed this out for Friend. Friend will fire. Oh, it's loose. And it's cleared away from the danger area. Kevin Carr again with a save. And the defenseman this time do the job and clear it away. Here comes Tedesco. Nazarian, top of the circle, feeds it back in for Tedesco. Tedesco in close. Oh, and Tedesco, oh, and it's a penalty shot being called by the referee. It's hooking is the call against the Stars. I thought initially that was good defensive play there. Let's have a look at this. Nice pass in for Tedesco. I mean, he's barely touching him, but hey. It's like resting his stick on his shots. So, penalty shot then.
Ice hockey's become a non-contact sport. I'm gonna say, I think that's a strange decision, but anyway, let's go for this.
Yeah, Tedesco, chance to make this 3-1, takes this in close on Carr, and Carr shuts the door. Not tonight, pal, not tonight.
Thank goodness justice was done there. That was a very odd one from the angle we had, anyway, that was a penalty shot.
Just looking across to the Stars bench, and you can see there is Jake Elmer, yeah, making his way off the ice. Doesn't look too comfortable there. Cooper ties up with Ingalls. Puck is loose. Johnson trying to work this round, but it's Giants in possession. Good strong play on the boards for the visitors. Prince. No way through for him there. Oh, nice work leaving the zone. And forward comes Rinaldi. Rinaldi takes this in close, chance at the back door and across the line. Rinaldi does a hard work down the left-hand side and sticks it across the blue paint and there at the back door for the tap-in to tie things up at 2 goals apiece with 17:49 left in the second period.
Yeah, huge goal here for the Stars. The work here of Rinaldi to get this laser on the plate for Craig Garrigan, who slots it in the net. Huge goal for the Stars, huge goal for Craig Garrigan, and absolutely fantastic work from his teammate Rinaldi there to set that up for him. That is Craig Garrigan's first goal of the Elite League season here in the DIA, and well, the fans are off their seats, the noise is back, and well, I'm kind of happy this has happened because I love when both these teams are fighting at it against each other, Dave, and it's close and there's a lot to play for. Such a good game.
Even in here is Norris, who'll send this one round. Nazarian closing in, loses out in the corner though. Stars move this up, it's Nass. Nass, sends it across to Britain and it's a giveaway chance here for Belfast. Hits the frame of the goal and ding goes the bell and it goes high. Stars will knock this away. Oh, Garrigan's through. Great work from Garrigan. Oh, that may have been a hint of a penalty coming there. It looked like the referee was putting his hand to his mouth, but it didn't. Throw this back again. Shot comes in this time. There's a hand in the air to the other side of the DIA. And Beskowani is on his way to the bench. Extra skater is on for the Giants. Well, they scored in this exact circumstance in the first period. Here come Belfast again. Prince sends it over. McLeod on the line. Cross ice for Gendron. McLeod again. Shot comes in. Deflected wide of the target. 15 seconds left on the power play. Another one from McLeod. Oh, and it's tipped in at the back door. Well, the pace and the movement around the zone there for Belfast is the undoing of the Stars, I think. And tipped in at the back door. Another power play goal for the Belfast Giants, and they take the lead with 10-16 left in the second period. Dundee 2, Belfast 3.
Yeah, with 12 seconds of the PK left for the Stars, the Giants score on the power play and take a 3-2 lead. It's a huge one here. Let's see where this game goes next. 10-16 left of the second period.
Giants then over the line. Covers back for Curtie. Curtie trying to make some space for himself, but he's closed down quickly by Harms. And here is Valentini. Valentini moves quickly. Still going in, Valentini, trying to drive that one in. Whoa, what a save from Pescovani. Sean Allen pushing this back in for Valentini. Valentini steps around through the blue paint out to the other side, smashing that one in. Oh, Giants have still got this. Oh, Chip and Colin coming. No, nothing coming. Never saw anything here. Giants in down low. Work this out, and it's plucked out the air by Kevin Carr. Britton into the corner for the Stars. 3 minutes to go in the second period. Phillips give away, turning fire, and a pad save from Beskrawani. Well, the Stars have forced a couple of errors in the defensive zone here for the Giants. And there is Carr with a cover on the loose one. Stars play this one up. No way across the blue line, though. Oh, they've got a chance here, though. It's Valentini makes some space for himself, shoots and scores! Ryan Valentini goes far down with that one. Ding goes the bell, and off goes the buzzer. Tied at three with 19:21 left in this game.
Well, let's watch this thing of beauty back from Ryan Valentini. He gets the opportunity, he gets that putt, and he knows exactly what he's about to do with it. He scores his fourth goal of the season, and look at this absolute cracker right into the top corner of the net. It's Dundee Stars 3, Belfast Giants 3, right at the start of this period, and this place is absolutely buzzing now. And rightly so, what a game this has been. I tell you, the Stars maybe need to keep these Freddy Krueger jerseys for a few more weeks.
Yeah. Well, the Stars' top point scorer of the season adds to his tally a very important goal this evening.
And he deserves it as well. He's had a good number of opportunities and been involved in a lot of the Stars' creative play this evening. A well-deserved goal, and well, he's at a level peg, and here we go. Let's see what happens next. I think they heard us, Dave, saying that we didn't want to see the Giants get that next goal in the game.
And, must have. Dumped in by Walker. Walker will give chase. It's nipped in there ahead of everyone as well. Helps it on its way around the corner. Out to the line. Quickly comes in. On its loose at the back door. And Pescovani covers in the nick of time. Puck still in play though for the Stars. Fired by Pouncey and across the line. Kyle Pouncey fires it from the blue line, and it's just sneaked across the line and no more. And the first goal of the season for Kyle Pouncey gives the Stars the lead with 17:14 left in this game. Dundee 4, Belfast 3.
Well, you'll never know unless you take the shot right. Kyle Pouncey did that indeed, and he scores his first goal for the Dundee Stars, and a huge one that allows them to take the lead against Belfast Giants, who have not lost any of the last five of their games. A lot still to do, but this is a good scoreline for the Stars to take with 17:14 left of the third and final period. It's Dundee Stars 4, Belfast Giants 3.
To the corner for Belfast. Giants though come away with this one. Big rush now for the Giants on the right hand side. Offside is the call, and that will shut that move down. And the crowd are looking for a call on the corner there after the check on the boards. Ryan across the line, drops this one back, and that move has broken down. There's no one there for the Stars though to take advantage of the error. And Preston across the line. Oh, I was just about to say he's lost an edge, but the Stars have taken a penalty for that, and that's going to be one for the replay. I thought he'd just fallen over there. Referee thinks otherwise, and Craig Moore is heading to the box.
Yeah, well, this is a huge chance for the Giants.
So, out to the line. Send it across for Cooper. Cooper back into the centre. Give and go. Back to Cooper. And then Curti sends it across now for Preston. Cooper was destined for the pass there. Intercepted by Garrigan. Stars unable to clear this away at the moment. Ingles battling hard in there for the Stars. That's bounced across to the boards in the corner. 30 seconds gone on the power play. Giants will move this all the way out. Cycle this around there. Here is Curti. For Cooper, miscontrol from Cooper, hits his shin pad, I think. Giants in down low. Chance for Preston on Carr. What a tremendous save. The backdoor play again, but this time it's denied. Puck is still in play though for the Belfast Giants, and there's 1 minute to go on the power play. Move this out for Curti. Fire down in the tip is there, and Carr will hold on. Giants though out the zone. Here comes Sato on the left hand side. Puts the brakes on and he's immediately closed down. And the Stars will clear this away. Jake Elmer takes it across the line. Oh, nice hander from Elmer. Shoots one in. Big chance on the rebound and scores! Sliding down on the follow-up. Bursts the back of the net with that one pass. Tyler Vescovani. And there's 7:34 left in this game. Unbelievable. It's Dundee Stars 5, Belfast Giants 3.
Yeah, well, we said the place was jumping before that goal. Well, it erupted there. Driving down with a huge one to give the Stars a two-goal lead. A lovely pass here from his teammate, or a shot, sorry, should I say. And the puck fell in the process to Dryden Dow, who rattled it in the net. Dundee Stars 5, Belfast Giants 3. 7:32 left, and we're about to see something magic here. Or are the Giants going to come back like they have before when the Stars have had a two-goal lead against them? 7:20 left. And we'll know the answer. But irrespective of anything, this has been an incredible performance from the Stars this evening.
And Stars looking to clear this away, unable to do so. It's back in down low. Chance here for the Giants. In close, oh, great handling. And Carr just gets away from him, but the Stars will break out the zone here anyway. And nice work from Valentini. Shoots and lifts it just high. Oh, the confidence is flowing in the Stars team now. Pulled in by Jeff Baum, knocks it in for Preston, Prince, sorry. Oh, Beskowani's off to the bench. Extra skater is on for the Belfast Giants. Extra skater is on. Goaltender has been pulled. Empty cage at the other end of the Dundee Ice Arena with 3:45 on the clock. The Stars hemmed in their zone. Giants move this out to the point. Move it in down the right-hand side. Preston with a centering pass. Gendron pushing that one in. That's gone up high in the air. Bounces down on the left. Oh, it's just kept in the zone and no more. And it's Gendron again, tries one, knocks it across the face of goal. Hand in the air from Pavahalis. Gendron, the Giants continue to move this around, but it's bobbled across the blue line. They will need to reset here. Delayed penalty call has worked for them in the first period. No, this time we have a roughing call against McKay with 3:05 left in this game. He is heading to the penalty box. Belfast in the corner, there's no one on the point to get someone across now. Preston sends it across. Takes it back here. Now for Long, top of the circle. Long fires one, it's blocked. Pushes across to the other side. All the way through for Long again. Long out for Preston. Preston fires and Carr holds on. Face-off is done. It's the Stars who win this one. Dow fires that one up, and it's across the line. Dryden Dow seals the 2 points for the Stars this evening. An empty net goal with 2:33 left in this game. Dundee Stars 6, Belfast Giants 3. talk about a response from last week's defeat to Nottingham for the Stars. Sure, Mark Lefebvre will be quite pleased. He's going to speak to Swanee after this game. Stay tuned for that. Well, the Dundee Stars fans are making a heck of a racket this evening. Can't blame them whatsoever. Just hold this puck up, yeah. Just the inevitable, really. And the buzzer sounds. And a tremendous victory for the Stars this evening. 6-3 winners over the Belfast Giants. And a heck of a turnaround from last weekend. Two goals from Dryden Dow to put this game out of sight for the Stars. And Mark Lefebvre will chat with Swanee ringside after this massive win for the Stars.
Well, Mark, that's the noise you've been wanting to hear for weeks. How does it feel?
It's not about me, it's about the players. The players came to fucking play tonight. I'm sorry I swore, but they did. The boys earned it tonight. They stuck with it, even where it got down some goals. That's a start. That's a good starting point for us, and we got to keep this going. Now, we can't get too high. It's like when we lose games, we can't get too low. So proud of the guys. They get all the credit tonight that they battled through it, and proud of them.
Yeah, a lot of pressure on these guys going into this game, more than any other, I think, because of the results. But, I mean, you've said you're proud on there. What do you think the difference was tonight and you've been able to achieve this performance and result?
Well, we finally put together 60 minutes. When things went against us, we didn't put our heads down and we didn't sulk about it. We didn't pout. We just went back about our business and we went back after them. I know there's a good hockey team in that dressing room. They showed it tonight. Like I said, it's a good starting point for us to get things back on track. And, you know, we got another big game against these guys tomorrow. We know we're in for another big challenge, but every game's a challenge for us. And like I said, I'm really proud of the guys. Great week of practice by all of them. Just came back to work after last weekend and the weeks we've had. And, we go again tomorrow.
That's great. Thanks, Mark.
Perfect. Thank you.
There we go. Mark Lefebvre's thoughts with Swanee ringside. Apologies for the fruity language there. And while you're watching that, I can tell you, man of the match for the Belfast Giants was number 2, Jacob Friend. 1 goal and an assist from him this evening. Just leaves the man of the match award for the Stars. Quite a few candidates, to be fair. Who will it be?
Sponsored by Stars Goal Club, number 57.
It's Kevin Carr. Well-deserved man of the match performance from Kevin Carr. Then pick up 2 Elite League points this evening. A big win over the Belfast Giants. And Kevin Carr will lead the celebrations for the Stars fans.